mía, te resta solo la teresta solo, te resta solo la tua fantasía, tua fantasía, tua fantasía, te resta solo la tua fantasía. Ci vuoi cazzina a casa una agonia, ci vuoi pace in famiglia una follia, ci deve me una magia per me, ci deve me una malinconia, 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 ci deve me una malinconia.
Casa te, morite, di ragazzina non te fermare, morite, minate, la voce forte falla sentire.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Mickela Mallozzi. I am the host of the TV series Bare Feet, which you just saw a couple highlights from. I am so thrilled to be with all of you tonight. And we are going to be in conversation with my dear friend Milteri Tucker Concepcion for Capital One City Parks Foundation SummerStage Anywhere series. Now, SummerStage is New York City's largest free outdoor performing arts festival and has been a major platform for presenting renowned and emerging artists in New York for over 30 years. While health and safety guidelines prevent us from gathering together, SummerStage is bringing virtual performances to you anywhere throughout August and September. So be sure to look out for more performances at SummerStageAnywhere.org. Now, without further ado, I am so excited to introduce a dear, dear friend of mine and our other guest for tonight's SummerStage Anywhere, Milteri Tucker Concepcion, who is the founder and artistic director of the Bombazo Dance Company. And we are so excited. Hello, Milteri. Hello. Hola.
Good evening. Buenas noches a todos.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited we're going to be dancing tonight because it would never be an event with the two of us if there wasn't some dancing, right?
Of course. Dance is our life. Dance is life. So we have to do it.
We do. So tonight we're going to be talking about connection. I know you and I really, our work really relies on connection. For those of you who just saw that video before, I am just connecting with people around the world through dance. If you tuned in a little earlier to the SummerStage Anywhere series, there was a little bit of a premiere of a piece that Milteri choreographed, which we're going to talk about later. But connection through things like culture, identity, and community. Now, before we get talking, Milteri, I want to see us and you dance. This is why we're here. This is what brought us together. This is why we're friends. This is why we love each other.
Yes, definitely. I'm gonna perform a little bit of Bomba. And just for those of you who know about Bomba, who are Bomba, are part of the community, because of the quarantine, we usually have a conversation with the drummer. I have this specifically pre-recorded for you tonight. What you're going to see is the language of the dancer, specifically the female dancer. So without further ado, I am going to present to you how I speak to the dance, yeah, to the drum, and how I speak to the dance.
Thank you. Here we go.
Thank you.
All day. While you catch your breath, we just want to say, everyone who's joining us right now live for this SummerStage Anywhere series, this is Milteri Tucker Concepcion, Bomba dancer, founder and artistic director of the Bombazo Dance Company. And for everyone who's joining in, let us know where you're joining from. We've got some amazing people. We've got Brooklyn in the house, Will Burt. We've got Harlem, Kristen, Danny G, yes girl, Michael Hammer, Christopher Michael Hammer. A whole bunch of wonderful people. Just let us know where you're tuning in from. And again, this is SummerStage Anywhere, so you can be from anywhere in the world tuning in right now. It's a really special moment. So Milteri, tell us what you just did. What is Bomba?
Well, Bomba is Puerto Rico's dance, drum, and song dating back to the 17th century by enslaved and free people of color. So we have African roots, but also we have roots rooted within the Caribbean. So it is this gathering of community of drummers, dancers, and singers to celebrate freedom, to celebrate resistance, to really liberate and express ourselves through our body, our movement. And that expression is primarily done in with the drummer, right? It's a communication. So it's not only communicating, but it's a way of also challenging the lead drummer, o primo, like we say, because it is he or she doesn't know the movements that we're doing. So it is not like pre-choreographed like I did for you today right now. It is in the moment what you're feeling inside, right. How the rhythm speaks to you. And right. That's the beauty of Bomba.
I love it. I love it. Now, we have a really special treat because you and I are going to sit and talk about this idea of connection, how dance really, for you and I in our work, really connects us, especially tonight through Bomba. But we have an opportunity for a little bit to try Bomba, and we want everyone who's tuning in to get up and dance. Milteri was able, she has an incredible line of Bomba skirts. Mm-hmm. And you sent me one, so I'm so honored that I'm going to be dancing with an official Bombazo dancewear skirt. We'd love for you to teach us a little bit of.
Absolutely. And if you don't have a skirt, ladies and gentlemen, you can grab a scarf, a beach towel. And so if you're somewhere in the park or in the beach, you have a beach towel, or you know, just move your body. This skirt is really an extension of our expressions, right? So you can have a handkerchief. You can move your sombrero. Just anything. But what I'm going to teach you, Mickela, and the rest of the world is the basic steps. Okay. And since we have skirts, we're going to deal with our skirts.
Yes.
And a little bit of footwork also. Okay, so here we go. So let's start with the basic step. So there are four major rhythms, and of course, a lot of other rhythms to stem off of them. But we're going to start with the rhythm of Sika, which is the rhythm that I just performed for you. So we're going to start with our feet together. Oh, Mickela, here's how you actually close the skirt.
Yeah, tell me.
So let me just bring this a little bit down so you can see me. So there's two ways of holding a Bomba skirt. You can hold it to the side, or what we're gonna do today, right in front of you, the hip bones, go all the way down to the rojo.
Okay.
Okay, make sure it's not too tight, right? Make sure you leave a little bit of space and create like a half moon. So we can see our feet.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we actually traditionally, what we do have a penny skirt, underskirt underneath.
Got right? it.
But for purposes of today, we're going to hold our skirts. We're going to start with feet together, hands on your hips. Right? Bomba is about figure and timing. So the basic step is Sika, I want you to just tap with the balls of your feet right next to you, your right leg. One. And then switch to your left leg. Two. So you do that again. Three and four. Great job. So here we go. Five, six, seven, eight, and one. And two, and three, and four. Notice that your upper body also sways a little bit in opposition. That is natural. Okay? So here we go. Five, six, and we're going to take four steps forward. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, and two, and three, and four. take it back. One and two. Always alternate. Take it again, Mickela. Great job. And one and two and three and four. Take it back. One and two and three and four. Now the arms. If you have a beautiful Bombazo wear skirt like I have on, you have your right leg forward, your left arm is on your hip, and your other arm is right in front of you. Great job. Then switch, right, switch, and switch. Eso, muy bien. Oposición, eso. One, and one, and one. So si ca, keep going, Mickela. Si ca, you have the one, it's the downing. One, do, 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 one, do, 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 one, do, 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 one. Let's take four steps forward. Keep going, Mickela. Great job. Now make sure, Mickela, that when we pass through the center, just like in ballet class, like we're holding, we're going through first position, so your elbows don't drop. Right. So you have your elbows up. Great job. Relax your shoulders. Your feet are going right and left, right and left, and your arms are in opposition. Woo! It's a lot to think about. Okay, so we're taking four steps forward, six, a five, six, seven, eight, and one, and two, and three, and four, and back, six. Now take it around, Mickela, around yourself for eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. The last one, we're going to bow into your screen. We're going to pretend that our screens is the lead drummer, or what we call the primo.
Right.
I have here, right, the drum. So the first beginning of sharp percussive movements. They're very sharp and clear. So we're gonna take your right arm from your heart right across, right? So you can see me sideways, boom. Eso. So we're gonna go one, then switch, two, three, four, that's it. We're gonna take it side, right, left, right, left. So let's put all those three, four elements together.
Yeah.
So for the basic step, now in the Bomba community, traditionally, this basic step is done to come towards the center of the circle, which we call el bate. That's why we're gonna do a little circle right before for eight beats. And the last two of those beats, we're gonna start with the drummer, in this case, each other, Mickela.
Are we ready? Yes.
Okay, great job. Here we go, my cat, and we do a music. Five, six, a five, six, seven, basic step. One, two, three, four, take it around. Five, six, seven, eight, salute. And here we go. Forward, and one, two, three, to the side, and one, two, three, four. Great job, Mickela.
Yes, everybody's joining us. We hope you're dancing with us. This is Milteri Tucker Concepcion. She is the founder and artistic director of Bombazo Dance, and we are trying some of this Puerto Rican bomba dance, which is just so much fun. It is a workout, girl. Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Yeah, moving the skirt technique, it is a little bit of a workout. So the next step, Mickela, is I want you to just relax your arms, your wrists, and just go like this, right? Just swing your wrist from forward and back, forward and back, forward and back. Great job. Okay, you gotta leave them really relaxed. So we're gonna take again your skirt, right? And this is what I call the roll. We're gonna roll. For eight beats, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Great job. Then we're going to actually, our weight is gonna shift towards your right, and you're just gonna bring your skirt up, one. And your other hand is just gonna follow. So you're gonna bring your right arm in an L shape, yes. L shape, and then your other arm is just gonna follow. And then we're gonna turn for four beats. Yes?
Uh-huh.
We're gonna turn for four beats. So let's try this. Let's try this from the top up to here with music. So we can get a feeling of what works. Okay, here we go. Great job. Bomba puertorriqueña. Ritmo Sica.
Eso.
Here we go. Eight beats.
Perfect. Question. I have a quick question, Milteri.
Yes, yes.
Basic, is it the same foot, same arm?
Well, we do, yes. When we do in the beginning, great question. The step changes. It goes same arm, same neck because of the movement and the nature of the percussive movement.
Got it. So we start opposite with the basic, and then it's the same.
And once we salute the drummer, they start right leg, right arm.
Love it. Perfect.
One, two. For four, and then four to the side. Great job. You guys did it one more time, guys. Great job. Remember to breathe and smile and pretend that the drummer is right here with you. Basic step. One, two, three. Take it around. Salute.
Guys, we hope you're dancing with us because this is just so much fun. And you get to feel the rhythm of what we're about to talk about because Milteri's work is so extensive, not just in the Bomba tradition and culture, but beyond. So I hope you're trying it before we get into this beautiful discussion. All right, Milteri.
Yes, absolutely. Okay, so after the four basic steps, so remember, we did the roll. Let's go a little bit back. We did the roll for eight. We opened up our skirts, right? Mm-hmm. And then we're gonna step for four. We're gonna go right, left. So I want you to travel this a little bit back because we're moving forward with the next step. The next step is what we call corrido, right? Or I call it the choo-choo for my little ones. So you're basically, you're gonna leave your skirts up and then your feet are just gonna chuckle. Really connecting with the ground, knees relaxed. Yes, that's it.
Love it.
Okay, let's add down once that step, and we'll take it twice at the top.
Perfect.
Here we go. Eso.
Woo! Pose at the very end. What is that?
It's a Bomba pose. It's part of the figure, right? So we're ending, you want to end with a sharper percussive movement, right? When you're in your conversation as you're developing. So for the purposes of today's class, when we shrug forward, six, seven, eight, and we're going to hold it to your left. Boom. And we're looking straight to the side. Exactly. And this is a Bomba figure. Yes, exactly.
It's so much fun dancing with the skirt. Oh my gosh. So for anybody.
Yes, absolutely. Can we try it one more time?
One more time from the top.
Fantastic. From the top, everyone. Hey, Bomba. Here we go, salute. Ah, left,
more time. We got to do one more time.
When we do the last beat, which is a marking, right? We do the last beat, boom, we're going to salute the drummers. This is a form of reverence to say thank you. Because at that moment in time, we dancers become the drummer because we're controlling his or her hands. So let's do it one more time.
One more time.
Eso.
Eso.
One, two, three, turn around. Salute. Right leg. And stop. Roll. Make it stop. Eso. Now, to the floor. And here we go.
Oh my gosh, so much fun. I hope you guys had a wonderful time. Oh my gosh, we have so many wonderful people joining us today. And for all of you who are joining us for SummerStage Anywhere, let us know where you're tuning in from, because you don't have to be in New York right now. You can be from anywhere. That's the beauty of the SummerStage series that they started doing virtually. And I'm here with Milteri Tucker Concepcion, artistic director, choreographer, dancer for Bombazo Dance Company. I'm Mickela Mallozzi, host of a TV series called Bare Feet, where we actually feature Milteri in one of our episodes.
Yes, that was so much fun, Mickela.
So much fun, so much fun. So let's talk about why we're here, because you and I, our work, and all dancers' work is about connection, right? We really talk about connection. But let's talk about connection in regards to culture, because right now, I'm looking at your shirt, well, when we were dancing, and you could say, it says, let's make that drum talk. Right? Tell us what that means in the Bomba culture. Tell us what it means in what Bomba culture is and what it's all about. What is it? Because we're just able to feel just a little bit of it just now.
Yes. And when you have live drumming, it's forget about it. You know.
Yes, girl.
So Bomba is a self-expression. It's connecting with the rhythm, connecting with your ancestors, connecting with your community, because it's about a multi-generation you have from your elders to the little babies all together when you experience this in the island or away from the island, right? Like here in New York. Yeah. So it's about family and being together. And because as a dancer, and when you come and you see the drumming and the singing, the dancing is just so unique to each individual, because the way they're listening, the way the drum is speaking, it could be the words from the song that inspires you, right? It just takes you to another level, another dimension. Not like you lose control of your body. It's not a trance.
Right.
Not a trance. This is something that's secular, different from other forms of Afro-Caribbean dancing. It's a little bit more secular. So the dancer or the drummer can be of any religious background. But when we come together, it's about celebrating us, celebrating those who came before us and those who are with us and those who are going to be with us in the future. So when I say, let's make that drum talk, it was a slogan that I created, because it's what I feel when I go into the bate. And it's exactly what each dancer does. And there's something about in Bomba when the audience is looking and is feeling, and you can see that they're feeling the dancer. They say habla, speak, right?
Yes. Habla, oh my God, I'm getting chills. Oh, I'm getting chills of you saying that.
So
oh my
you God. Hear them because they're connecting with your expressions in that moment, right? And again, it doesn't have to be with the skirt. The skirt is just an addition. It's another element. It's another level to that experience, but it's coming from your corporal movement, right? We move our hips, we move our feet, we move our shoulders. So there's so many layers to Bomba. It's specifically to each dancer. So when I say, let's make that drum talk, it's exactly what we're doing. Because at that point in time, the drummer, when we salute the drummer actually looks at you. And I have an experience, and I always say it, with one of the Bomba families, with Jesus Cepeda. right? When he can be drumming, he can be like in his groove, but when the dancer comes to challenge him, that man stops even his hand from doing the main rhythm. That's why the bulleador, right, the other drummers continue the rhythm, because now he is looking from head to toe at the dancer.
Yeah.
Remember the challenge also, it's a duality, right? It's a conversation that's happening simultaneously. The drummer does not know, it's not premeditated, it's not a pre-choreography. He or she needs to do his best or her best to match the movement of the dancer. Then the dancer also needs to learn, know the rhythms, right? That's so important why when you're in the community, learning really, because not every rhythm is different, it's danced different, it's expressed a little bit differently.
Yeah.
So when we come there, the drummer is like, he's like looking at you from head to toe. I mean, you can't do, I'll do, you can read it, I'll do a master.
Yeah. But what's amazing is, so for people, you know, any other dancer, you're like, okay, I get the music, mm-hmm. and then I choreograph a piece to that music. Now, Bomba is different because the drummer, who's the musician, is making music based on the moves that the dancer is giving. So it's this role reversal, which I love.
Yes.
As a dancer, you feel empowered because you're dancing up there and I make a move and that drummer makes that hit. You know, I mean, I'm not a professional bomba dancer, you are, so the hits might be a little off, but it really is this empowering moment of I am speaking because the body movements I'm making are sounds that are coming out of the drum.
And even if you're off of a dancer, he has to follow you.
Yes.
Right? Because at that point, that's what I say, it's an extension of my slogan is we become the drummers.
Yeah.
The dancers, right? And then sometimes it just you and the drummer become one in the conversation.
I love that.
It. Incredible. It's a feeling. So that's the beauty of Bomba, where again, other Afro-Caribbean styles of dance, you may have a simultaneous talk, like he talks and you talk, but here, we completely take over. When we salute, we are like saying, hey, you know, I'm here, I acknowledging you, and that's the start. And that's very intimidating when you're first starting. So that's why, you know, I believe my mission is to guide our community and our people to get over that fear, because it can be a little bit intimidating. And people of the community knowing.
Now, last point on the culture, because I think what's really important to understand, I had the immense honor of also going to Puerto Rico, to San Juan, and meeting with Tata Cepeda, who's one of the matriarchs. They're her family. There are families, Bomba families, right?
Yeah.
Are legacies in this Bomba tradition. And you mentioned that Jesus Cepeda, the drummer, you got to dance with him. I mean, these are our legacy families that have passed down rhythms, dance moves, dances. Talk a little bit about the tradition in these families. What does that mean? What does that look like?
Yeah, no, definitely. Like you said, they're depending on the region, right? Like the Cepedas are more what we call a recangrejera in Santurce. It's a little bit over when you lay at San Juan or Calorina. It's depending on the regions, right? So you have the north, their dance, and they have a particular style as Loisa in the west and the south. And basically, these families took it upon themselves to continue this legacy, even when government officials, generations past, decided to say, hey, you got to stop this, they outlawed Bomba. So what these families did is like, you know how we dance a groove to hip hop or salsa in a birthday or, you know, a special event, because a lot of Bomba also happened with some religious, Catholic religion events, right? For example, for us, so La Fiesta de Cruz, for example, in Puerto Rico, that's an adoration to the cross for those who even know about that. There's also Latin America. So, and then after the mass, then the community will come up with the drums and then we'll have a bombazo. So they kept it alive through generations, and people like families like the Cepedas, the Ayalas, the Albizus in the south, right, the Alduens in the west, decided to we have to record the music, because if not, it's going to be lost. And you know what happens? Things change through generations. The bomba that we dance now, I firmly believe, is not the one, the same exact one that we danced, the enslaved danced, right? It has evolved. You have influences also from the Caribbean, like St. Thomas, Guadeloupe, Martinique, Trinidad and Tobago, right? Yeah. We have all these influences of people passing through, coming, and being a part of the Puerto Rican culture. So, and then we adding more into the culture. So, you know, thankfully to these families that are tributed, we can say that the longevity of Bomba is because they took it upon themselves. If we don't conserve this, our next generation and our future generations are not going to have this. And this is who we are. This is our identity as of Puerto Ricans and as Afro-Boricuas.
Yes, yes. Well, this leads right into the next topic, which is perfect, talking about connection through identity. Now, you are a perfect example of how that evolution, like you said, you're not dancing the bomba that your the enslaved ancestors from Puerto Rico did. It's changed, but you've almost taken it a step further. Can you tell us about Bombazo Dance Company, your influence? You know, all your dancers aren't Puerto Rican. Like, tell us a little bit about your evolution and your identity through bomba.
Right. Well, for me, bomba for me is connecting and representing. These are my African roots. You know, yo soy orgullosamente negra y puertorriqueña, right? And I'll translate it. I'm very proud of my blackness and being of Puerto Rican descent. Mm-hmm. And for me, it was about keeping that tradition again here, because Puerto Ricans will come in different shades and colors and sizes, right? Yeah. And what does that mean? We're leaving home, which is our home country, we're going to somewhere else, diaspora, right? So we take it our culture with us. But also within the new environment, what we have is that we have a little bit of Dominican and Puerto Rican, Dominican and Cuban, Dominican and Haiti, you know, half and half, a quarter or whatever, but still connected to Puerto Rico. Yeah. So for me, it was about conserving as a dancer, as a professional dancer. You know, I dance everything, right? But yeah, for me, it was, Bomba, when I, you know, Puerto Rico, I didn't know West African dance. That's not something that's taught in Puerto Rico. So when I came to study here at Hunter College, I was like, what is this? I'm taking this class forever. It's like, yeah. So that I'm seeing the connections to Bomba, seeing where the African roots are coming from, right? And being a voice also for the Puerto Rican community is showcasing the image. So I as a choreographer, I had a voice needed to be expressed. I had so many ideas that I wanted to take Bomba, not only maintaining it, it's just what I do, but also how can we further take it to the next step, right? So what I did was then create the company, which is a fusion of traditional Puerto Rican bomba with then modern contemporary styles of dance and even street styles of dance, right? So I fused it with, even with the Second Life from New Orleans, you know?
Yes.
The ballet, dances, and part of the of what we know in the performing arts, because I want to take Bomba to that level, and it has the potential to be at that level. I think I'm already doing
it. You are.
So, and then having that dialogue is something fresh and new. We've done it with other styles of Afro-Caribbean dance. Why not with Bomba?
Mm-hmm. I love it. Well, let's talk about this piece, because you recently choreographed a beautiful piece. And for those of you joining us, we are with Milteri Tucker Concepcion. She is the artistic director at choreographer, dancer for Bombazo Dance Company. And you did a piece called Como Eres, As You Are. And I went out into the world during Pride, which was absolutely beautiful. For those of you who checked out the pre-show, there was a full presentation of it. But I think we have, before we start talking about it, I think it speaks for itself a little bit. Let's have just a little snippet of what Como Eres is.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I love that piece. I love that piece so much. And it goes into this whole beautiful representation. You're in the piece, there's other drummers. It's spoken word. It's really beautiful for everybody who's on here. You should definitely watch the entire piece. But Milteri, tell us a little bit about your inspiration for creating this piece, producing it, and also who the dancer is. Who is that?
Absolutely. I start with the dancer. It's my good friend, Cedric Leyva, junior Puerto Rican actor, dancer, singer, musical theater performer. He's amazing, amazing, amazing. And now he's watching. So, hola, Ceri.
Hola. Beautiful job, Cedric. That was just wonderful.
Yes, yes. So I wanted to challenge a little bit the traditional roles in Bomba, right? So normally you have your female with your skirts and, what we just did, the communication, and then the male is more about movement of the feet and a handkerchief or hats, right? Part of the inspiration was that over the years, there's been a debate about within the community whether a man should have a skirt or not dancing bomba. A few years back in the early 2000s, before social media became what it is today, there was a young man who put on a white skirt in a bombazo in Puerto Rico, and he started performing, dancing in the language like a female. And that was perceived, had mixed reviews in the community, and kind of more negative than positive. Fast forward now that we have that liberation, right, and non-binary, still, I think there's still a little bit of hesitation, when somebody comes out, oh, can they or not, depending on who the person is. And I kind of wanted to challenge that views. Why? Because women have challenged the male version and perspective in Bomba. Before, traditionally, based on what was passed on orally, it was just a man sitting down. But now we have, amazing women drummers in Puerto Rico and here in the States. They're saying, no, we can learn that too, right? And I have a calling and affinity, and there's some fierce women drummers. And also dancers, some of the dancers challenge, I'm going to dance and make the movement as the female of the male. Or combining both, right? As again, the evolution, and we are moving forward. So I wanted to represent and give a voice and say, it's okay. If you feel comfortable, you don't have to pay a mind to anybody. Put on your skirt and dance it. If you know the language, if you know the culture, forget about anything and then go. And there's a few dancers in Puerto Rico who are now starting this trend as well. And it's just so beautiful to see that now the acceptance a little bit more wider in the Bomba community. Also within the Puerto Rican community, they can be a little bit strict and giving a voice of for example, in February, there was that really got to me, and mom, oh my God, I can't believe, what happened to this transgender woman in Puerto Rico, and her name was Alexa. And I say, we're in a new century. This should not be happening. We need to be more receptive of who you are and speak your truth. And they were speaking, there are people who are speaking their truth, living their truth, and dancing their truth. So for me, it was very important. If I'm going to take this and move this genre forward, if I'm saying that Bomba is for all, you don't have to be Puerto Rican to dance Bomba, then it doesn't matter if you're male or female, as long as you know the culture, you know the history, and you're dancing with respect. As long as you're doing it with respect to who you are, living truth to who you are, it's all good with me. So I talked to Cedric, and I said, Cedric, I have this idea. We were going to do it a little bit differently. I was going to choreograph it with more males, but because of the pandemic, I said, Cedric, do you mind of, how do you feel dancing this? It's a new role for you in the company. And he says, I tell him, we need your voice and your experience, and your voice is going to help others too.
Yeah.
Weekend men who can identify with your story, and that's this whole beginning. Identify with who you are in that female energy. And if you feel like you want to grab a skirt and a bombazo, préstame la falda, let me get your skirt. So what I'm saying is, with respect to the elders, because if you want to do traditionally, you can. But I'm saying, let's move it forward. We're in a new century. We have this power. We can create change. Let's create the change positively and give everybody a chance to feel the drum and to make the drum talk.
I love it. We have so many wonderful people on here who are just supporting this. Yes, Bomba for all. Danny, of course. We have Cynthia saying, Wepa, Cedric, yes. Power to you. This is just so cool. And drumming is healing for everyone. I mean, it is. It is so powerful. It is so uplifting. And I'm sure it was very cathartic for Cedric, I'm assuming. Let me know if I'm wrong, but I feel like if you're able to express yourself fully, especially in the arts, it is just so powerful. Yes. So powerful.
Yes, absolutely.
I love it.
And also liberating.
Yes.
You know, and he even said, like you said, ooh, Mickela, this girl is a workout.
It is. Well, dancers know this, you feel better after you dance, but I think, you know, I've had you on, I started a Bare Feet Live series where we're on social media every week dancing with people around the world. You were one of our guests, but every single week we just take about 45 minutes and just dancing, and we can't travel, so we're able to travel via social media, but through the voice of dance, through the language of dance, and that's another way of connecting. So, which leads me to our last topic of community, because this is exactly what you do, this is what I do. Like I said, we did Bare Feet Live. I'm trying to stay connected with the world through dance when I can't get in a plane and go somewhere, but also staying connected with our viewers who really feel, I mean, if they feel it as much as I do, I miss dancing with people. I miss hugging you, Milteri, and dancing with you.
Hello.
You know, but this
one day.
Yes. But then, you know, I'm so grateful. We are so privileged that we have access to social media platforms where we can share this with hundreds and hundreds of people aside from just ourselves. I think it's a real honor that we live in a time where if COVID had to happen, we're pretty lucky, you know, considering. But I want to ask you, you know, for you, for community, you know, for connection, how do you stay connected within the community? You're not just a performer. I mean, there's so much more that you do within the community.
Right. No, I'm an educator, right? Yeah. When you're a choreographer and you're passing down knowledge, right? And I think anybody who is folkloric or has a folkloric background or, you know, something that's cultural, it's very meaningful to you. And I've worked with other amazing choreographers. One of them is my sister from another mother, Cynthia, who just said hello.
Yes. Yes.
And, Peruvian and Puerto Rican. So, you know, working with her, getting the connection of her roots, it's the same thing. It's passing that along. As an educator, I give the classes to the community. And I said, I wanted the classes to be without any attachments or like, oh my God, do I have to pay $20 for a class? No, you're gonna get amazing instruction and history and knowledge for free. And so I teach all the way from our babies, our children, to the adults and all their seniors. And a part of the community, because Bombazo, and that word Bombazo, right? It means it's the community in Bomba, ¿verdad? So, you know, we had in the past, it's called Toques de Bomba, Bailes de Bomba, and then recently a Bombazo. So I wanted that to be the essence of how do I pay it forward? You know, Bomba, it was a gift. So we have to continue it. So I pay it forward through education. And one of the ways that I did, right, because I teach the babies a lot,
yes,
is through writing the first bilingual Bomba children's book.
Yes, you sent me a copy too. Oh, it's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Look at that. Well, what's really fun tonight is we're doing a giveaway, Milteri. Yeah.
Yes, it's illustrated by Mia Roman, another wonderful, powerful queen, Puerto Ricana, Mia Roman, who did the illustration. It was very important for me to be a woman in Puerto Rican. And yes, we're giving a giveaway.
We're doing a giveaway. So we have two books that we're giving away throughout the entire evening. So if you share your favorite SummerStage Anywhere moment, include the hashtag SummerStage Anywhere and Bomba Puerto Ricana. I hope I'm saying that 100% correctly. Yeah. But it's Puerto Ricana. There we go. Bomba Puerto Ricana. And share your favorite moment using hashtag SummerStage Anywhere. For the next 24 hours, we're going to be picking a winner tomorrow. And you are going to win a book. We're going to give two away. But we're going to give one away right now. Right, Milteri?
Yes.
right now we have a question. The first person to answer in the comments, what year was SummerStage founded? What year was this amazing platform? And I gave a little hint that it's over 30 years old in our introduction. So that should give you a little bit of a hit. First person to post what year SummerStage was founded, you will win a copy, signed copy of Bomba Puerto Riqueña by Milteri Tucker Concepcion.
And this is great, not only for Bomba practitioners, for educators, for musicians, for dance enthusiasts, and music, for anybody who just loves culture and you love having a book. It's so important to have books, and it's illustrated so beautifully, and it's about the history of Bomba. So my intention was to educate.
Yeah.
So the kids, our children and their parents and their grandparents, if they didn't know, you know, sometimes we just want to Google things real quick, but how about just going back to the old way of going, having a book and a reference?
Yeah.
Written by somebody in the community. It's very important that we tell our own stories and our own histories. Yeah. And, you know, Mickela, I was like, what? There's no Bomba children's book? What is this? You know, a couple of years back, you know, like you, I love traveling and I travel the Caribbean. And everybody else had a book about their history of music and dance. And I said, what? So I said, well, let's just, we got to do something about this. And I just did the research and created this with me and Vermont. So, you know, this is a dream come true. We have a second book coming out soon.
Love it.
About the history, it has colors, it's illustrated very beautifully. It's simple enough so you to learn it and pass it down.
Love it. I love it. I love it. We have a winner from, and I'm only doing it by the timestamp, so don't, no one get mad at me, but Sandy Sanchez from our YouTube live, you are the winner. We will be reaching out to you. I guess if SummerStage wants to send a message to Sandy Sanchez, thank you so much. The correct year of founding of SummerStage is 1990, which I cannot believe. That's unbelievable. Absolutely amazing. Now, what I also love too is you don't have to be Puerto Rican to also love this book. I mean, look at the cover. I have a little bit of a glare, but maybe let's put that cover back on. If we show the cover of the book. Let's see. So you see, you know, with kids of all colors, shapes and sizes. And that's what I love about this book is that, you know, Puerto Rico is a melting pot of cultures. And yeah, what was your inspiration to do that? What was your inspiration to be so inclusive, you know?
You know, I teach, when I go into the elementary schools here in New York City, I don't just see
Puerto Rican. We put the wrong date. It's not 1990. I messed up. It's not Sandy Sanchez. I'm so sorry. Try again. It's not 1990. Everybody, whoever can. I got so wrapped up in the book. I like totally lost it. Everybody who's on here, whatever year that SummerStage was founded, you get a signed copy of this book. So there's still time to win this book. Okay, I'm sorry. Keep going.
You still have time, Sandy. You still have time.
You still have time, Sandy. We have close ones. They're coming up close, but they're not cigars.
So, you know, as an educator here in New York City, I don't just see Puerto Rican children. I see children from all over the world. And for me, it was important that every voice was represented. Mm-hmm. And that they could connect and make a connection, because it's about not only learning about Puerto Rican culture, but connecting and making connections to your own culture, right? Because we all different. We all say that, like, for example, Kenepas is get it somewhere else. You know, it has different words in the around the Caribbean, right? I'm going to take it when we go to Ponce. We're going to eat some Kenepas in my hometown.
We are going. As soon as we can travel again, and I are going there. We're filming a new episode of Bare Feet. We are there.
Yeah, so I wanted the children and their parents and the educators to be able to have accessibility, whatever it is, you know, whether it was for Hispanic Heritage Month or for Black History Month or for Women's Month, to just have this available for and make the connection for the children, for them to see themselves. They need to see themselves in our book.
They do. And we have a winner, Crystal Morgan. Oh, 1986.
Sorry, Sandy. We still got still have two more times, Sandy.
There's two more ways to win. Congratulations, yeah. Crystal. There's two more ways to win. You can post your favorite SummerStage Anywhere moment for the next 24 hours. We are picking a winner tomorrow. Actually, it's like the next 12 hours. So you have until noon tomorrow. Post on any social media, whether that's Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, use the hashtag SummerStageAnywhere and post your favorite SummerStageAnywhere moment, and you are in the running to win this incredible book. And if they can't win the book, you know, not everyone's going to win. Where can they find this book, Milteri?
Well, they can find the book on our website, bombazodanceco.com. Also, it's on amazon.com, Bomba Puerto Ricana, and soon it will be in Libro 787, which is a Puerto Rican platform, Puerto Rican authors. So, but definitely bombazodanceco.com. Our website is in our landing page. You can find a book, you can find a t-shirt, you can find the head wraps, you can find the skirts.
I love it. Yes. And these skirts are just absolutely incredible. We only have a few more minutes left, but I mean, we could be talking about this forever. Yeah. What I love, you know, about community is, let's talk about what's happening right now, right? With the Black Lives Matter movement, Bomba has really sort of evolved, as it's always evolving, into this dance of protest. Can we talk a little bit about that? Tell us what's happening with Bomba in this.
Yeah, no, definitely. Within our community, you know, usually the way when I was raised in Puerto Rico, the music of protest, I was very easily to go. It was the plena, which is another form of Afro-Puerto Rican music that originated in my hometown of Ponce and has roots in St. Thomas in the U.S. Virgin Islands, right? Mm. So, because it's very easy, so call and response. But because the new generation, they're really connecting with the African roots. They're really paying attention. They're accepting that other part of them, right? And they're taking it to the forefront. Mm-hmm. So we see a lot in the island and in the diaspora here in New York, in New States, I should say, more groups, right? Musical groups. We see more people educating. We see more people dancing bomba. So because of it's about Black Lives Matter, it's about highlighting the issues that affects the people, the Black people in our communities, and for us it's the Afro-Boricua community. You know, we don't see each other so much, you know, our hues and our different hues of Blackness. We don't see it too much in the Hispanic world as much as we should see it. So it's taking on a role of we're present, we're here, it's been here. So we're going to dance and we're going to take it to the streets and we're going to bring this energy of the drum, right? Because the drum has always been there. It's that force that guides us.
Yeah.
So with this energy of, you know, resistance, it because it survived, right? It survived so many no's, that now, because we have so many people engaged with their Africanness and with their in their these African roots, it's like we're gonna showcase this to the world, right?
Yeah.
So that's the beauty of it. It was social media and with the platforms ever engaging and technology just blooming, it just made it so much easier. Like back when, you know, you needed to know people, you needed to know the events, you know, there was no social media or anything. It was by word of mouth.
Yeah.
Now the word of mouth is to click or a post, and it's just so beautiful because it brings the unity, the community together.
Right? It does. So
that's important. But for me, besides being resistance, is showing our liberation and our power. You know, this is the power that I have and that I'm exuding when I listen to the rhythms and when I dance. So it's about that. Always that we've always been in an essence free to move. So since life is about movement, right, we have that freedom to express ourselves.
Yes.
We bring it forward with the movement of Black Lives Matter.
Yes.
But at the same time, we're showcasing we've always been here. We honor our elders. We pay it forward with our children. But we've always been here.
Yes, yes.
And here we are.
And that is the legacy of Bomba. I mean, of all the obstacles for it to even exist, and that the parallels of that for Black culture, for Black people, you know, it's so, the parallels of it are just overwhelming, you know, and you know, drumming wasn't allowed, and they found a way to make music when they couldn't communicate within the same language. They used drumming to communicate. It's just this beautiful, beautiful way of resistance, of existing, of test, and now to translate that for today, it's quite powerful. So,
yes, absolutely.
I feel so honored to have you here tonight. I feel so honored to be on the SummerStage Anywhere series with you. I mean, this is just a huge, huge piece of New York, you know? I don't know about SummerStage. You were supposed to tell us, you were supposed to be performing.
I was going to be with Uptime Vinyl, a few members of us. I'm so thankful for SummerStage because SummerStage is about community. It's about the dance community. It's about bringing people together and cultures together. And I love SummerStage. You know, I've been to so many of SummerStage of emerging and established dance companies. It is free. So it's just like you want to be a part of this and be present and support other artists who are doing their work and paying it forward as well. And that's the beauty of SummerStage. And now that we can view it anywhere, it's just even more amazing. You know, not only about, you know, I remember when I used to go to Central Park and then from there it's in different boroughs. And Bombazo Dance Company has had the privilege to dance in 3 SummerStages in the Bronx. SummerStage for that opportunity. So it's just so exciting, right? And we were going to be in this year, but Uptime Vinyl, but that's okay.
And you know what? I have to say, you know, SummerStage is really supporting artists in such an incredible way during this time because they have pivoted and found a platform and a way to facilitate the arts to still stay alive, right? We are so grateful for SummerStage, to create SummerStage Anywhere, to keep these sessions going. And so we're super excited to be a part of it. I'm speaking on behalf of both of us because I just love SummerStage. And like you, I went to so many concerts in Central Park, and for years, it's just part of your New York summer. That's what New York summer is, it's SummerStage.
And I want to thank again SummerStage for premiering As You Are, Como Eres. Special thank you to Cedric and also Dominican Rican Productions who directed the film and the Notice blog for filming it. This is truly about community, and their mission is also about highlighting our voices and voices who are underrepresented in the media, film and media and jazz. So I just want to thank them and thank SummerStage for that honor, this honor. We really want to be inclusive. Bomba is for all. It's para todo el mundo. And let's continue to make the drum talk.
Now, I'm going to say a quick goodbye, but at the end, can we just run through our dance one more time? Is that okay?
Oh, yeah. Yes, absolutely. We'll
do it. Before we do that, I just want to thank you all for joining us for this special conversation. Be sure to tune in Sunday afternoon, August 30th at 2 p.m. Eastern for a special live from SummerStage Anywhere. The people speak Sunday, and our guest creator, Tamia Santana of Brooklyn Dance Festival on the SummerStage on Instagram, on their channels featuring guest host, former Alvin Ailey star dancer, Duana Smallwood, and more. Please subscribe to the SummerStage channel and check out SummerStageAnywhere.org for all the events. And remember, if you share your favorite SummerStage Anywhere, remember to share the hashtag SummerStage Anywhere moment. You can win a signed copy of Bomba Puerto Riqueña, the beautiful book by Miss Milteri Tucker Concepcion of Bombazo Dance. Thank you all so much for joining us. This was so much fun. Time flew by, Milteri. Oh my gosh. We're going to do this one more time. So if you were here from the beginning and you know the moves, or if you just want to join us right now, let's do this and we'll send everybody out. Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone.